Cawffee Talk. We are here again with Lauri Stern, and we are going to be discussing today our fifth chakra, which is the throat chakra. And the color is obviously blue, as you can see by Lauri's lovely background. But yeah, this one's kind of interesting because, like, zillions of years ago, when I was in the advertising industry business, I always had sore throats, and somebody told me once that it's because of my throat chakra being blocked.
Yep.
And interesting, because I had a voice that nobody was listening to. And I think that's really interesting how it manifests itself.
It really does. And that's like such an obvious duh.
Yeah, totally.
And we don't, you know, I had a friend like all through high school who constantly had throat stuff. And now that you just said that, I'm going to circle back and see. I know there was stuff going on that she couldn't speak about. Mm-hmm. And that was probably just enough, you know, what was going on. Mm-hmm. But that is one of the main, the throat constriction and actual sore throat. Mm-hmm. You got to listen to that.
Definitely.
Yeah. So that's great. I like when you start off with a little story like that from yourself, because it's so universal, really. And we just don't think about, you know, we've talked so much now because we're all the way up to the fifth chakra about our body's messages, and that it really does do us a service if we're ready to listen to it and believe it. That's the other key too. It's oh, that can't possibly be really why that's happening.
Right.
So it's just enough to sort of say, perhaps it's possible and I might want to take a look at that, mm-hmm. you know, which is a whole different energy than someone saying you must or have to. Mm-hmm. Because then I feel like when someone says that, you know, some of us immediately resist that,
right?
Depending on who's doing the speaking or if we trust their opinion.
Right.
Yeah.
My favorite word in the English language is should.
And any self-esteem sort of seminar person will say that's the worst word in the English language.
Yes.
Hey, right. Don't should on me.
You should do that.
No.
I should just like exist. Don't tell me what I should and shouldn't do.
Yeah. There's a whole don't shit on me movement out there.
No, I like it.
Yeah. We'll make shirts.
Yeah. Don't shit on me.
Yeah. Don't shit on me. Right. It is such a sneaky word too, when you think about it, because when you're saying you should blah, 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 mm-hmm. it's really couched in criticism. Whoever's saying you should blah is clearly not coming from a place of love and adoration for the
person,
in my opinion. I mean, they think they are. But when you should on someone, it's a whole different energy than you might like to try, or have you thought about, mm-hmm. you know, putting the ownership more on the person versus being bossy as the speaker, you should do this. So this is a good time to talk about the fifth chakra, which is Visuddha, and there's 16 blue petals you can see. And so when we talked about the heart chakra, we talked about it being the bridge between the lower chakras and the upper chakras, right? So the lower chakras, they've got triangles that point up. And so our fifth chakra is the first triangle by itself that points down. So again, as a reminder, it's bringing spirit to the body, to the ground. Mm-hmm. And so our fifth chakra is all about speaking our truth. It's our authentic self. It is how we communicate, speaking, singing, breathing, all of the sounds that you make with your throat. If you're a chanter, the sound of this one is ham, like H-A-M. And so ham, 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 ham. And the key of this one is D. Okay. And so, you know, I sing, you're a wonderful person in my life because I sing. And so how you express your voice, right? And just what you said, you know, if you're at a job where you don't feel you're being heard, mm-hmm. that manifests in that throat constriction, right? So this is all about not only what you say, but how you're interpreted by the people receiving your words. And so it's also, and it's a mirror, right? So when you speak, are you being misunderstood? And are you leaving room not only to be heard, but to listen? Mm-hmm. So a lot of us, especially those of us who are passionate about something, can bulldoze over other people. And so when you take pauses as you speak and leave room for conversation, mm-hmm. That's what the balance is about with this chakra. And so would you like to add anything right now?
No, I'm just fascinatedly listening. This is great.
Because we know those people, like you're in a meeting, you're in a group of people, and there's always that one who like monopolizes the whole group. And you sit there, you're like, can you take a breath? Can you pause?
One of those coming up today at 6 o'clock. Yeah.
Really?
I'm excited. Yeah. That'll be she's just always just talking over everybody. It's really hard to, especially with the Zoom thing, it's really hard to just say, hey, wait.
Yeah. I know, because then the boxes, you know,
it's a little difficult, but that's okay.
It's funny because of the Zoom, you know, so, you know, I've got four kids, there's six of us in the house, there's five of us right now, but you can imagine a dinner table conversation can get pretty lively. And, you know, I'm one of six, also four kids and parents. And so I like the chaos. I like, you know, to me, a normal conversation is interrupting each other. Like everybody wants to be heard. Everybody has a valuable thing to say. And my husband comes from a different way where everybody takes a turn. So there's sometimes discord about
very organized
who's right. and like how do you fit in? So the Zoom, that's like the worst for him because he can't, to him, everybody's interrupting each other.
Yeah. It's totally like that. It's very chaotic and it's very difficult for people who are so organized to just be like, okay, wait, one square at a time.
One square at a time.
That's all I can do.
Right. And to me, it's like, that's just normal. So, you know, so the way we know we can be out of balance in this chakra when we have a physical sore throat. Mm-hmm. We know we encounter ourselves or others when there's too much talking. There's no room for anybody else to add to a conversation. And, you know, how loudly you speak versus another to the other end in balance is shy speak, very soft voice, really raising a hand meekly, you know, not quite sure if what I have to say has value, right? So that's kind of root chakra. So the way the other chakras start to build up to this one is in your root. If you don't feel you even have a right to be here, then how can you possibly have any value in what you say?
Yeah, exactly.
And then in your second chakra, how creatively can you express yourself? Do you even know what to say and how to produce it? So it's not just about speaking, but if you hear your voice and write, but you don't, you know, writer's block, you know? And then your third chakra, are you really speaking from your gut? Are you tamping that down? Are you too fiery and too verbose, or too meek and not really, you need to turn that, you know, fire flame up. And then in your heart chakra, this is a really big one. Do you speak truth? Because that's what this is about, your authentic truth self. Do you speak your truth with love? And that takes a lot of practice too, because we want to be good friends and spouses and parents. And we're all guilty from time to time of just speaking in the moment.
Yeah.
But when you can come from a place of love, it's a whole different energy. Even if you have to give somebody bad news or discipline somebody, if it comes from a place of love and balance there in your heart, they can feel that. Yeah. If hopefully, if they're also equally able to receive that.
Right.
You know?
Right.
And then, you know, so how you vocalize then is all about this chakra. And again, the ears. So neck issues, neck tension, you know, good way to sort of get in here is like to do some slow neck rolls. I, you know, in class, I don't often say take your neck back in a neck roll because we don't know what's happening with our blood vessels back there and our little tiny bones. But if you know you have a healthy neck and you can sort of, I prefer to do the waddle stretch, you know, bottom lip to top lip, versus just throwing your head back like a hip hop.
Very sexy.
look like a cartoon character. Like the opening of the throat. So in yoga, we do lots of back bending and camel poses, and you know, anything that's going to open up the throat. And at the same time, if you feel in yoga, I'm talking about that you're a little too out of whack to the pingala, the fiery side, then plow pose and bridge pose that kind of bring your chin in. But again, you need to be careful what's going on with your neck.
Right.
If anybody out there has yoga questions, you can ask me. But so just movements like that, and, you know, rolling of the shoulders just to make space at the neck, that also kind of opens the throat and softens
it. What is the hand gesture for this?
Yeah, the hand mudras, there's two of them that I offer. One is called Aksha Mudra, and it's really easy. It's just connecting your middle finger and thumb. Mm-hmm. And, you know, it doesn't have to be up here, but it might be nice. You can give yourself a little, you know, little massage for your chin, if you want. And or just lay it in your lap. And then the other one that I like a lot is called Nat Mudra. It's Grantita Mudra. And so you interlace your pinky, middle, and ring finger only. And then here come those two loops again with the index finger and thumb, but you interlace those. Mm-hmm. So you make a fist kind of, and then you interlock and interlace that. Yeah. And then you, what I like about it, and I've done this in class too, is you can really kind of rest your chin. So it lands on the back of the throat. When you speak, you can feel the vibration of your vocal cords against your hands. Mm-hmm. And then you can kind of just take your chin like a little pillow. Mm-hmm. And this is called Nat Mudra. It unlocks the knots that might be residing here. So if you feel like you're in that meeting and the advertising and you're not being heard, it's just a nice thing to do. And it really does. And you can even lay back on the ground and get in and tap into this.
Oh, that would have been cool to know back then, just laying on the ground in some sort of pose. Maybe that would have
right. Gotten, no, I was just thinking about even at dinner, you know, I've talked about like under the table, index finger,
right.
You know, this, you know, at a dinner table, if we're allowed to put our elbows on it, you know, you could just kind of rest.
Yeah.
And see how that feels. Yeah. In right. The middle of conversation going on around you, and you want to take a little notice of if you're being heard or mm-hmm. recognized as a speaker. Mm-hmm. You know, so ways to get into this at home is obviously singing and having conversations with people, calling people on the phone, speaking. How do you feel? What are you really wanting to say? How you express yourself, whether it's fear, joy, anything at all, just practice speaking out. And this is also the chakra that where we stand our ground and stand up for ourselves. So, you know, the self-esteem comes back into play here, whether you're low or high, but, you know, can you stand your ground? You know, do you stand up also for others? Mm-hmm. And we know that can be imbalanced too, if you only give to others and not give to yourself. Right. So, but this is that chakra where we practice really just being present, clear, and communicative mm-hmm. about who we are, what we have to say, mm-hmm. and listening to others in the same way.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Cool. And I imagine there's not a whole lot of blue foods out there besides blueberries.
You know, so right. So blueberries and the obvious blue foods. But what's interesting is, and I didn't remember to look this up, but fruits from trees, and I have to think it's something about, you know, because trees are rooted and they represent the chakras yeah. too. So yeah. when the trees bear fruit and they're juicy, apples, pears, you know, you think about plums, all those juicy fruits that, you know, that you can feel them down the back of your throat. They're really good to eat for the chakra. And in the same way, soothing hot liquids, just drinking water, because the color, you know, like mm-hmm. the blue ocean, drinking water is anything to soothe the throat, but hot liquids with honey and lemons also come from trees, they're juicy, but those nurturing things, soups and teas and hot toddies, right?
Awesome.
But you know, wearing blue clothes and wearing blue jewelry, if you're a lapis lover like I am, this is my favorite color. So we're these chakras, you know, this one and the next one, they're my color family. And which is interesting because I obviously like to speak and sing, but just wearing something blue of any color mm-hmm. can sort of help you tap into the chakra.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Cool. And I don't think there's anything other than I wanted to talk about the jewelry because we didn't talk about that before.
Oh, yeah.
And there's my friend Laura Radigan, you know, she owns Soul Shine Collection in Highland Park, and she's like the stone guru, the crystal guru, mm-hmm. and she's the healer, and she does Reiki, and if I go to her when I want to know if I feel a little out of balance, you know, is there crystals that I can put right. on my body, and so she helps me with that.
And so the lapis is one of the ones that would be for the
throat. Yeah, lapis.
Because we didn't discuss that before. What are the other ones? Because we,
You know, I would have to get back to you on that because okay. I know for sure lapis. I want to say labradorite is a blue, anything turquoise. Okay. You know, but different. So the thing about, so that's not my wheelhouse. And I caution to say that because there are stones. I just know this from Laura too. There's stones that we can attach to with color, and that's great. But there's some stones that emit a vibration or attract a vibration mm-hmm. that in our best effort might not be the right one for us, depending right. on what's going on. So you go to someone like her and say, you know, I have no trouble speaking, I have trouble listening. Mm-hmm. But might not be as simple as lapis. It might be a whole other bag, literally a bag of tricks of stones. And so it's really cool to talk to somebody who's a crystal worker and a body worker, because it's all connected, you know, how we open and balance these chakras, you know, we can talk about it, but there's yoga and foods and healing and, mm-hmm. and people that have wonderful information out there that, mm-hmm. that equally are passionate about how you tap into chakras in their wheelhouse.
Yep.
And so I want to leave room for that.
That's good. That's great. Then we should all go visit your friend in Highland Park.
And
check her out. Absolutely.
She's amazing. I mean, she does these live shows at night on Facebook too. And you talk about someone who's got passion. It's like you with your coffee cup productions. She opens up a box and it's like, she's just greeting her most special friends and her favorite children. They're all her favorite children. And you can tell it's like, she wants to keep these things for herself because she's so excited, but you know, they're for sale. And it's just a pleasure to be around people when they're really, really speaking from their joy.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's true. That's true. Most people vibrate on that level. It's really awesome.
Yeah.
To be around people like that.
Yeah.
Sure. Cool. Is there anything else about this chakra that's unusual or special or something we need to pay attention to?
Watch out for how you feel constricted. Mm-hmm. And speak. And breathe. You know, in yoga, we talk about ujjayi pranayama, which is the hissing sound at the back of the throat. Mm-hmm. So if you practice that, if you want to learn how to practice that, it's like you're fogging up your computer screen or your glasses and you say, ah. Mm-hmm. And then that's the vibration at the back of the throat. And then we do that with the lips gently closed. And we bring the tip of the tongue just behind the top teeth. Mm-hmm. And it's like, I call it mother bear breathing because my kids know. If I'm practicing my ujjayi breath, there's something I should be saying and I don't want to, so I'm just gonna breathe. But it's a really good way to tap literally into your throat's vibration, open it up, and it also heats and calms the body. So it's a kind of breath that does a few things depending on what you're looking for it to do. And so that's a good thing to practice at home, is all that right. kind of breathing. Yeah.
Cool.
And lion's breath. I think we did that in class and you open up and you're like, ah,
oh, right. Yeah.
Literally tongue down as loud as you can. Especially for those people who are a little shy out there. Just making a ridiculous noise like that, that vibrates your throat also just, and it opens up your ears too, by the way. It really does invigorate this area and it's transformative. Like if you're afraid to make noise, you know, check into why or how, and just make some noise, you know?
Yeah.
Go outside.
Go outside and make noise. Nobody's out there right now. Go ahead.
Use your outside voice in your house. Why not?
Yeah. Awesome.
So it's just, it's just express yourself, speak, but speak from your heart if you can.
Mm-hmm.
And say what you mean and mean what you say and let other people speak and
mean what you say is a big one, I think.
That's
a very big one. Yep.
And also like asking questions, you know, did you hear me in the way that I intended? You know, you can kind of see someone's reaction. So don't leave that conversation. Say, you know, did I just do something? You know, was I misinterpreted? So leave room for that exchange. You're not always going to be right, in the way that you think you are or not right, but like interpreted in the way you think you might be. And so leaving room for people to say, here's what I heard you say. Is that what you really meant? That's a great conversation exchanger, cool. In my opinion. We don't ask those questions enough. Did you really get what I was trying to say to you? I hope so.
Yeah. I think that's cool. That's a very nice thing to start to implement in things. I like that. That's a very
See, someone wants to talk to you.
Apparently, yeah. So did my dog. I'm not sure if you can hear my dog whining in the background. He wants to talk to me too.
Well, this is wonderful. Thank you so much, Lauri.
This is awesome. Thank you so much. And we've only got two more left. So I'm very sad that there's only two more of these.
We'll be back again.
Come back for the last two, and definitely. Thank you. And we'll see you soon.
All right.
Bye.
Bye.